Well, hello, beautiful people. Welcome back. So for today's video, we are going to be doing a fun, very impromptu little foundation review, a first impression wear test on the newest foundation launch from ColourPop. This is their new Pretty Fresh Hydrating Foundation. And I did pick it up from Ulta in two different shades. I have Fair 20N and Fair 30N. I do just want to let you guys know, I mean, obviously you can tell, but I am filming this very, very early. And not only am I filming it early, but I'm also filming it on a day where I normally wouldn't be filming at all. So it's going to be a little bit different in terms of visually how it looks. Again, there might be sun popping through, whatnot. But that's just the tea on that. And truthfully, I don't think anybody cares. I think you guys are here for the foundation review. And I think that I think we've talked enough. So let's go ahead. We're going to zoom the camera in and let's get started. Okay, guys. So I'm good and zoomed in. I'm going to start off with a little Tatcha Liquid Silk Canvas. I'm just going to take that all over the face, just like I normally would. In terms of priming the skin, this is one of my most consistent primers, whether it's this one or the balm one. I like both. And I think given that this is a more hydrating foundation, at least that's how it's spec'd out, I think that this would be a good primer to pair with it. And then while that's soaking into the skin, let's go ahead and pull up the information. I have it on the Ulta website. And something that I just wanted to share with you guys because I thought it was funny. Normally, when I do a foundation review, concealer, palette, like it doesn't matter what type of review I'm doing, normally I make a point, like a dedicated point of not looking at reviews. Because whether they're like YouTube reviews, online, you know, on Ulta, whatever, I try not to read reviews because I don't want my opinion to be swayed. Well, I clicked on the Ulta website this morning to get everything pulled up, and it says that this currently has 3 out of 5 stars with 2 reviews, and I'm like, my God, how could people hate it already? Like, what does it say? Guys, there are literally 2 reviews. One is a 1-star and one is a 5-star. The one that is 1-star says that this is patchy, creased, doesn't cover anything, not spreadable, causes acne, and clogged my pores. Wonderful. All the things I definitely hate. Well, then you go to the 5-star review, of course, which is just above it. These are a day apart, by the way, that the reviews are. And the 5-star review says, my new favorite. This foundation is so pretty. During the hot months of summer, I don't like the feel of full coverage foundation, but I still would like some coverage. It has just enough coverage to get rid of my redness, but it doesn't feel cakey at all. I really like it so far. I just thought I would share that with you guys because I thought it was ironic. You know, the one time I look at reviews, it's like, wow, it's either really, really awesome or it's a hot fire dumpster trash shithole garbage. And you have no idea knowing which one you're going to get until you put it on your face and wear it. So I guess that's just where we're at. But it's down into the details here. It says that this foundation is a hydrating foundation, which we know. It says that it delivers medium buildable coverage with a natural skin finish. It is infused with coconut water. So be mindful if you're allergic. I know a lot of people have irritations with coconut, but it says it's infused with coconut water and hyaluronic acid for hydrated, luminous skin. The flexible formula provides undetectable medium to full coverage that lasts all day. This vegan foundation is dermatologist tested, or it's dermatologist tested. I mean, you can see a dermatologist if that's really your thing, but maybe stick to dermatologist. It's oil-free, alcohol-free, and fragrance-free. Ooh, I like, okay, fragrance-free. I am so on board for that, okay. So here they are out of the container. Again, I grabbed them in the shades Fair 20N and Fair 30N. And then as far as the shade range goes, I'm just swatching both of these shades really quickly. The shade range, I wanna say on Ulta right now is 29 shades, and on the Trend Mood post, I want to say there's going to be a total of 55 shades in the line, and the entire shade range line will be available on the ColourPop website, I want to say within a week to a week and a half, something like that. Again, don't quote me. If there's any more information or if it is available, I'll leave it down there as I'm editing this. All right, now here are the 2 shades that I picked up. I have Fair 20N and Fair 30N. What's interesting is that both on camera and in real life, I would say that Fair 20N is almost coming off with more of like a pinky undertone than Fair 30. To me, Fair 30N looks way more neutral undertone. It has more of that that baseline undertone to it, I think, than this one does. But I think in terms of like the color and the shades, I think they both look pretty good. Now, as far as the colors themselves go, I did just kind of work them into the skin a little bit. And I think on camera, Fair 20N, which is this side, looks a little bit better. But when I go over here and I actually worked in 30N, while both of them do look a little bit light, I feel like this one I'll be able to work with a little bit better, just because the undertone matches a little bit nicer. So I think I'm gonna go in with 30N. That's gonna be my final answer. Now I do have a couple of pumps on the back of my hand. I just wanna show you guys as far as the viscosity of this. It is a very, very thin formula. So just something to keep in mind, you know, if you have like a texture preference. And I'm just gonna go in here really quickly and get this applied. Again, this is the shade Fair 30N. Yeah, that's definitely a little bit lighter than normal, but I can definitely make that work. Because you know what? Even on camera, I'd say that it looks brighter on camera, like as far as the tone difference. But in real life, it's actually melting in really well. All right, guys, so I went ahead and I got the foundation all over the rest of my face because there was a parade of lawnmowers and tractors going by anyways. So I figured I would just, you know, take these couple of minutes to get it on and applied. And up close, I don't think it looks that bad. It does look like, to the plus, it does have like a hydrating, more dewy, more luminous effect, which I think is really pretty. But the main concern of mine and the concern that I'm seeing going forward is that on the skin in my more textured areas, it does look or feel like it has kind of a combined effect there where it's a little bit heavy. From here, I'm gonna go ahead and just keep doing my makeup like I normally would. But because it's so hot out lately, and I don't think I mentioned this yet, but I haven't been wearing any makeup like this past week, especially like out to the office anywhere, because it's just been so unbelievably warm. By the way, I don't know if I just said that or not, but this is the Dose of Colors Meet Your Hue Foundation in the shade 3 Fair. Truthfully, it's hard for me to know what I have said and what I haven't said because there's literally so much noise going on outside. And from there, I'm just going through and setting down the T-zone first with a little bit of my Hourglass Translucent Veil Setting Powder. Just a little bit here, just to get those areas good and set down first, because those are by far my more creasy areas. I like to use that one, you know, through the T-zone, like I said, under the eyes, my more creasy areas. And then all over the rest of my face, I do like to use a foundation powder. I feel like that's been working really well for me lately. And mainly I've been using this one. This is the Too Faced Born This Way Multi-Use Complexion Powder, or foundation powder. And this is in the shade Cloud. And I'm just gonna go through and really press that into the skin. And this brush is a little bit more dense than I would normally use. Normally it would be a fluffy brush, but just to get it pressed into the skin, it won't make too much of a difference. So I'm just going to go in. This is the Velvet Luxe 319. Now, for those of you that don't set your face, I do want to stop right here and just do a little side-by-side comparison, just so we can see kind of how it looks. Because for me, I kind of expected, given that this is more of like a hydrating foundation, I did expect it to have a little bit more luminosity to it. And right here, this entire plane of my face is unset. And you can see a little bit of glow coming through, but like for there not being any powder right here, I mean, there's a little bit under my eyes, but all of this area, like the large majority of it, is unset. And it looks nice on the skin, don't get me wrong, but it doesn't have like an overly like glowy feel to it. I am a little bit thrown off by that, but again, you know, that the glowy part of it, that could just be something that comes out later on in the day. So let's go ahead and move over to this side. Again, this entire part has been completely set down with powder. So in terms of, you know, the surface glow and all of that, you probably won't see as much. But what I am really liking about this side is actually how good and how like smoothed out it now looks over the porous areas of my face, like right through here, because I was just mentioning that those areas looked a little bit more aggressive. They looked a little heavier. And once I went in with powder, that did seem to calm that down a little bit, which I'm pretty happy about. And then for those of you that do not set your face as well, I'd like to do a little touch test just to see, you know, how well this dries down. And I do get a little bit of transfer, but for the most part, I think if you don't like to set your face, I think you could, you know, use this one without setting, because it doesn't seem to be giving me a lot of movement or a lot of transfer, both of which are two things that I do look for. All of that being said and done here, let's go ahead, keep moving it along. I'm going to get this entire side set down now. And then from here, with everything powdered, I actually really enjoy the way that this is looking, like especially right through here. It does have like this luminosity that's coming through the skin, and I'm very interested to see how this looks once I have like my bronzer and blush and all of that on, because I feel like, you know, right now I look a little bit just like flat Stanley pasty white, but once I go in with the other stuff and I sculpt out the face, I wonder, like, I think it'll complement all of this glow that's kind of coming through, especially once I add a setting spray. So I am going to go ahead really quickly, run off of camera and get, you know, bronzer, blush, the light amount of stuff done, and we will stop back on here and assess the situation. So hang tight and I'll be right back. And all right, beautiful people, with that, the rest of my makeup is on and applied, and I just got a phone call that says I'm going to have to jet in about 5 minutes. So I want to run through really quickly. I want to tell you what I used and get into the up close. And I'm gonna go ahead and start off actually with the rest of the makeup that's on my face, because I want to cover it just in case you are curious. As far as the face products go, like I said, I didn't go into like any crazy amount of makeup today. I did my Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Airbrush Bronzer in the shade Medium. For blush, I did, of course, the Lunar Beauty Moon Prism palette. I'm obsessed with this. And I mixed these three shades together, which is Twilight, Stargaze, and Soleil, just for a little bit of something cute on the cheek, a little luster. I added that little fella on on. So that is the blush. For highlight, I used my Lunar Beauty. This is the Moon Prism Powder in the shade Mercury. And I used this all over my face. It has like this beautiful undertone to it. You can kind of see it right in this area. It's absolutely stunning. For brows, I went in with two products, both of which were sent to me from Benefit. I used the Goof Proof Brow in the shade 3 and the Brow Gel, the Gimme Brow, that was in the shade 5. For lips, I used a combination of the Wayne Goss Lip Liner, which is in the shade Sepia, and the Lunar Beauty Gloss, which is in the shade Moon. And for eyelashes, for mascara, I went in with the ABH Volumizing Mascara. And I almost forgot, you know, given that I'm wearing eyeshadow today, it's been so long. I did go in with the Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Eyes to Mesmerize in the shade Marie Antoinette. And then over top of that, I have a little bit of the Hourglass Scattered Light Glitter Eyeshadow in the shade Smoke. And then from there, of course, let's go ahead and get into the up close. This is the part where I think, especially for today, it's very exciting because, guys, my skin looks really, really good right now. Like, I'm really impressed. Truthfully, like I said at the beginning of the video, you know, when I first started to apply it over my more textured areas, it did have like this heaviness to it. The foundation did, and I was very apprehensive. But now, just looking at my cheek, even in an area where I applied what I'm going to say is just copious amounts of highlight, and it should look a little bit more textured, a little more emphasized. My skin just looks really good, and it has a nice light filtered effect even like right through here. Now, there is only one thing I want to add to the flip side of this, because again, I think my skin looks nice. I don't have any complaints in that respect, but there is a little bit of like coverage that I think was lost right through here. And the only reason I know that is because I do have more redness, more hyperpigmentation, more acne in these areas. I have really bad cystic acne. And I noticed that right through here, when I applied the foundation, it was more covered. And now if I look at it, there is a little bit more of it right here that shows through than what was there originally. Again, you know, if I look back or think back to when I had first applied the foundation. So the flip side of that, if I'm being completely fair, do I feel like I lost a ton of coverage? No, I feel like I lost maybe, you know, 10, 15% coverage. It's nothing that's super crazy, even super noticeable, probably to somebody that's not me. But because I'm in here and I am under these lights and I'm really critiquing it and pulling it apart, that is something that I noticed that I wanted to mention. And really quickly, just before I run off of camera, it occurred to me while I was putting on my mascara, I didn't tell you guys how much this costs. So this foundation is available on Ulta and it is currently $16. Like I said, it will be linked down below, but I just wanted to remember to put that out there because that does kind of matter, Paige. People like to know how much things cost. But anyways, from there, I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna go do my day, and I will talk to you guys in a little bit.
Well, hello, beautiful people. Welcome to midway through the day. I just wanted to check in super quick. I've been wearing this foundation for roughly 6 hours, 6-7-ish hours. So we are well into the day, but I still wanted to stop in for a couple of reasons. So number one, I just got back out of the store. Obviously, I was wearing my mask, like a good doodle, wear your mask. But I wanted to just show you guys, as far as like the mask wearage on this, you are going to get a fair amount of transfer. Now, I'm not surprised by that because this foundation is a hydrating foundation, so it does have more of that transfer, you know, aspect to it. It's not like super long wearing. It's not more of a matte finish. So as far as that goes, it's a little bit of a bummer, but I still wanted to bring you guys in just so you could kind of see how we're looking out in natural light as far as this foundation goes, because I think over the cheeks, again, you just saw it on the mask, right? It had a lot of like transfer look to it, but when you get up to the skin, I mean, right in this region, it doesn't actually look super like transfer-y, which I think is pretty good. The main area that's looking rough after the mask though is the nose, like right up here, which, as somebody who has like combo leaning oily skin, I'm not super surprised by that because, I mean, truthfully, like that's just what happens, you know, you're oily through the T-zone, this area does tend to break down quicker. But I did think it was something to note. I mean, just again, if you are wearing a mask, if you're wearing it in your day-to-day, it's kind of something that, you know, I think at this point in time we need to incorporate into our, you know, foundation wear test. And I know at this point not everybody is like wearing a mask in their day-to-day life. A lot of you are working from home, and you know, if you're not leaving, that's fine too. But I still wanted to include it because it is, you know, very relevant to kind of what's going on. Again, just as far as like transfer wear test, that sort of thing. So that's number one. And then the second thing I want to mention really quickly is actually my forehead, because it's currently 81 degrees out, so it's really, really toasty. And as far as I mentioned this morning, you know, I wanted to make sure we looked at this foundation in the aspect of it being summer and it being warm out, what happens if you sweat, you know, that sort of thing. And I just wanted you guys to see up on my forehead, up through here, it's not really showing in this light all too bad, but right up in here, I noticed earlier that my foundation was breaking apart a substantial amount. And at this point, I really don't have anything else to report. I just wanted to stop in and let you guys guys kind of see, you know, how it wears throughout the day as far as those other little things are going. But overall, the rest of it, like I said, it's wearing pretty well. I am a little bit shocked right through here. I feel like maybe it's just when it's in the light or something, but I feel like it's looking a little bit heavy, like right through my texture on both sides. But anyways, I'm gonna go really quickly because I just glanced right there and that car is staring at me. Like the person, they're literally, like they're not even trying to hide it. They're just like stop it right now. Like me looking through my fingers like a creep. Anyways, I'm gonna stop in here in a few hours. I'll give you my final thoughts, but I just wanted you guys to get a little shot of how it's looking out in real light, out in natural daylight. And I will talk to you guys here in a little bit.
And all right, you guys, here we are. It is officially the end of the day, and I've been wearing this foundation for a freckle over 10 hours at this point. And of course, we are here to give my final thoughts, wrap up, close up, all the good things. So I think the best place for us to start, you know, obviously rounding this whole thing out is with the up close. That way we're both looking at the same thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw that up on the screen for you guys so you can take a look at it. In terms of the actual foundation, you know, I think you guys can see for yourself at this point in time, it is looking a little bit rough, but you know, again, just to reiterate, I have been wearing it for just over 10 hours. It was a very, very hot day today. I was outside a few times. I got a little sweaty. It was very, very warm. We're talking like a high of 88. And overall, you know, if you take all things into consideration, I think it would make sense at this point in the day for the foundation to be a little bit, you know, a little bit funky looking. Let's go ahead and start off that pro-con list was something that I did mention this morning, and that is just how well and how impressed I was that for a hydrating specced foundation, this did work very well with powder. I definitely think that's something that, you know, not only lends itself to the foundation and to how good it looked this morning, because, I mean, it was looking smooth, it was looking really nice, laid, slayed. It was very, very beautiful on the skin, and that was whether I was in here under these camera lights or if I was out in natural light. It just looked very beautiful all through here, so that is a big plus on its own. But I also think it's a big plus because it lends itself and makes it a little bit more versatile across the board as far as what skin types it will and will not work for. For example, I'm someone who's combo leaning oily, as I mentioned, so I do have to set my face. And knowing that, it makes it so, you know, this is something that could work for you if you're maybe on the drier side. It could also work for you if you're leaning a little bit more oily. And just that by itself covers a wider array of skin types. Then I think that that's a really cool attribute to have. Again, especially for something that does have more of a hydrating aspect to it. Now from here, another thing I think we need to touch on is the hydration aspect of this foundation, because not only is it, you know, specced out as a hydrating foundation, but I really feel like it's very much so driven in the marketing aspect for that. And when it comes to hydrating foundations or any foundations in general, I think it's important to remember that there is a huge scale of hydration. You know, all the way to this side, you're gonna have like the Fenty Hydrating or the L'Oreal Pro Glow, you know, items that are very, very hydrating. They look luminous on the skin. They make your skin look more luminous throughout the day. Like they just encourage that glow on your skin, and they do it from the very beginning. That's of course all the way at this end, versus if you go all the way to this side of the scale, you're gonna see things like the Smashbox 24-hour full coverage foundation. And again, that one is a very full coverage. It's very, very hyper matte, and there couldn't be a bigger gap between, you know, those two genres. All of this to say, you know, if you have the super glowy over here and you have the hyper matte over here, you have more of like that skin like more natural glow in the center. Something I would say kind of reminds me of like the Urban Decay Stay Naked. That one is very medium line for me, at least on my skin. I would say that this one definitely sat somewhere in the middle between that center skin glow and being hydrating. Like it definitely wasn't super duper hydrating on my skin, but it wasn't overly skin like and just like settled onto the skin either. It had a little bit of glow to it. Now to the flip side of that, something that I wasn't a big fan of with this foundation and something that I kept noticing over and over again, you know, as I checked on it throughout the day, I didn't love the fact that right through here on like the apples of my cheeks around my mouth, I did feel like those areas looked a little bit more, a little bit more like thick, a little bit more chunky. They didn't have the same like luminosity to them, let me put it that way, as I had hoped or as they had had previous in the day. So as this foundation does wear, if you add powder like I did, you could notice a little bit of that going on, a little bit, you know, just of that like luster kind of dying down. And that's not something that's super uncommon with a hydrating foundation, because again, a lot of people that look for those often don't set their face, or if they do, It's with like a really, really fine setting powder. So I think that there is room there, but it's just something that I noticed. You know, if you powder, yes, it will accept it, but it might give you a little bit of pushback throughout the day, and it might kind of dull that luster and that glowy look to your skin. You guys, from there, I can't think of anything else. So please be sure to let me know your thoughts and opinions down in the comments. If you want to check the foundation out, were you curious about it? Do you like the video? Again, thoughts, opinions, leave them in the comments. From there, if you haven't checked me out yet, Instagram and on Twitter, don't forget to do that as well. And of course, the most important, if you haven't done so yet, please subscribe and turn on your post notifications before you leave. I do upload 3 new videos a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and they usually go up around 7 a.m. my time. And with that, beautiful people, I hope that you guys all have an amazing day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!
Trying really hard not to get irritated.